So I'm gonna check my pasta water here. It sounds like it's coming up to a boil. Oh, there we go. You can see there. See those really fast moving, rapid boiling bubbles? That's what you want. If it's anything less than that, you don't wanna put your pasta in. Once it comes up to a boil is when you wanna add your salt. You don't wanna do it after the pasta's in or way before at the beginning when you just have the cold water. And this is really the one chance you have to flavor your pasta. So be sort of generous with the salt, because it's gonna give your pasta a nice flavor. And if you notice, I'm not adding any olive oil. Please, please, please don't add oil to your pasta. A couple reasons. One, I know everybody wants to do it because they think that it's gonna make their pasta not stick. But if you think about it, two stages from now, when you're putting your pasta with your sauce is not gonna stick either of it. So I'm gonna pour this pasta in here and immediately gonna start stirring that. So when you first put the pasta in, it does need a little bit more of some attention to get it stirred up, because it's sort of clumped together right now. So give it a nice stir, put the lid back on, and I'm gonna check it back in a couple seconds and stir it again. When it's a little bit more pliable, it'll move around better for me. So I'm gonna check this, and you could see, yep, it came right back up to a boil. So at this point, if you wanna take your lid off to avoid the volcano of foam going all over your stove and a mess of cleanup, you could totally do that now. So you could see too that my water is still relatively clear. It's not all mucked up with a ton of starch, because I have a lot of water in there and I have a big enough pot. So as you're going along here with your pasta, don't be afraid to take the lid off or try it whenever you want. I'd rather you taste it a whole bunch of times. That's the interior of that is way too stiff yet. I still am getting a real hard bite on that. It has some time to go still. So don't be scared to always taste your pasta. You're better off to taste it often so that you're not overcooking it, because you want to get it to that perfect al dente, which is that nice sort of chewy bite that you'll have with your pasta. But my kind of rule of thumb is if you take a bite like I just did and it sticks in your teeth completely, still a little bit too hard, you don't want it sticking in your teeth. So I'm gonna taste this one more time. It feels like in the fork here, it feels done. After a while, you kind of get a feel for it just in the fork before you taste it. So I'm gonna take one of these. Ooh. It has a really nice bite, not sticking to my teeth. And I actually am gonna take it off probably 1 minute before I think I actually should, because by the time I take my pasta water out, drain it, put it into my saucepan, it's still gonna cook a couple minutes. So you actually wanna take the pasta out at the moment, right before you think you should. I'm gonna scoop out some of this pasta water. This is really valuable stuff. I know it sounds crazy, but you can kind of see it has that nice starchy look to it. When you're making an oil-based sauce, even a red sauce, any type of sauce you're making, you always wanna save 2 cups here, more or less is fine, of your pasta water. It contains those really good starches that the pasta was cooking in.